Welcome to Unity Real-Time Training. In clinical laboratories, measurements need to be as precise and accurate as possible to facilitate high-quality patient care. Because it's impossible to conclusively achieve one specific result for any given measurement, clinicians need to understand how much potential error exists. This way, they can accurately interpret results and determine if a patient's condition has changed significantly or is outside clinical decision limits. This is why we calculate the doubt, or uncertainty, of a result. The Measurement Uncertainty Report calculates measurement of uncertainty to help you determine the accuracy of your results. The report uses expanded uncertainty, calculated using a z-score of 2, to increase the confidence interval of your results. What is uncertainty? Uncertainty is a calculable range that provides context for the accuracy of a result. The true value of the result is expected to lie within that range. Picture this scenario. You, a lab tech, receive a call from a physician. The physician is concerned about a particular patient's glucose result of 60 and requests that you repeat the test. To ensure repeatability, you repeat the test 3 times using the same sample. You receive several similar results. How can you be confident that your original result is accurate? First, you'll determine the measurement uncertainty range. The lower limit is the starting result minus the uncertainty value, and the upper limit is the starting result plus the uncertainty value. If your result falls within the measurement uncertainty range, you can be confident that your result is accurate. So how do you determine your uncertainty value? That's where the Measurement Uncertainty Report comes in. We'll be looking at measurement uncertainty for a glucose test. After selecting the test, click Reports and Measurement Uncertainty. Random and systematic error must be considered when calculating uncertainty. Unity Real-Time provides 3 built-in uncertainty formulas to help you easily calculate measurement uncertainty and manage a comprehensive result database. Each of these options calculates measurement uncertainty in a different way. When you select an option, the calculation and the parameters used to calculate uncertainty appear in the dialog box. The first option is standard expanded uncertainty, which calculates measurement uncertainty based on imprecision only. The next dialog box asks us how much of our lab's data we'd like to include. First, select a data range. Then, choose either the current lot or current test. In this example, we'll choose 6 months and the current test. Finally, click OK. Here we can see the software has generated 6 months of our lab's data for glucose. We'll use level 1 because the mean for level 1 is closest to our original patient result. In order to find our measurement uncertainty value, the software takes the SD for that level and multiplies that value by 2. The resulting measurement uncertainty is displayed in the last 2 columns of the report. The absolute value is the result you'll need to determine your uncertainty range. In addition, the uncertainty is also displayed as a percentage. Now that we have a measurement uncertainty value, we can determine our measurement uncertainty range. Take the original patient result and apply your measurement uncertainty value. Now we can see that our first 2 repeated test results fall within the range, so we can be confident that those results are accurate. Choose the second option to generate a measurement uncertainty report calculated using a combination of imprecision and bias. The bias values are derived from interlaboratory data, which helps provide an assessment of how your lab performance compares to a wider group of laboratories. Again, you can use the following dialog box to select how much information you want to include. In this example, we'll select 6 months of our lab's data, the current test, and the peer group bias. You can also choose to use the bias from the method or all labs group. Here, we can see our lab's glucose data for the past 6 months. The top row of the report shows the peer group data, and the middle rows show each individual month of your lab's data. The bottom row is your lab's cumulative data for those 6 months. In this example, for level 1, your lab's SD is 2.23, and your lab's bias is negative 0.39. The SD bias for the peer group is 1.51. Using the bias calculations and SD, the report calculates measurement uncertainty. Again, measurement uncertainty is displayed in the last two columns of the report as an absolute value and a percentage. Use the final option to generate a measurement uncertainty report calculated using a combination of imprecision and calibrator uncertainty. Using values from calibrator manufacturers, this calculation helps to provide an uncertainty estimate in the context of calibrator performance. Select the data range and choose the current lot or current test, similar to the previous options. You also have the ability to include test configuration items including method, instrument, reagent, unit of measure, or temperature. Then, enter the value for the calibrator uncertainty in the CalU column. The calibrator uncertainty value is manually typed in. In this example, we'll use 2 as the CalU value. If you would like the calibrator value to be a percentage, check the percent box. If you would like the calibrator value to be an absolute number, leave the box unchecked. You can find your calibrator value on your instrument manufacturer's Instructions for Use, IFU. The report shows the calibrator uncertainty you just entered. The report uses the SD and CalU values to calculate measurement uncertainty. Because we entered 2% as a calibrator uncertainty, the calculation for level 1 yields a measurement uncertainty value of 5, or 9.03% imprecision. Measurement uncertainty values evolve constantly. Laboratories should routinely review measurement uncertainty values, determine how often to calculate each assay's uncertainty, set performance targets for their uncertainty, and evaluate if their uncertainty is acceptable. Using measurement uncertainty, clinicians can interpret results correctly and determine if a patient's condition has changed significantly or is outside of medical decision limits. For all of your QC needs, visit www.qcnet.com.